Can you continue my series that Halifax is a mess? We're by Morris Street, and I don't know what the name of this other street is, but I want to show you something besides the fact that the manhole is uneven, and whoever did the work here didn't put a proper curb in. But you see this big hole right here by the curb cutout? That's been like that for 3.5 years, and you wonder why is it that the people that live in this city or in this neighborhood have never called the city to let them know, can you please fix this? Because people, isn't just down the street is Nova Scotia Rehab. And this is really, really dangerous, because what happens here is that if you're in a wheelchair, you have to drive down the street in your wheelchair to get up on the sidewalk because the curb cutout is broken. And as you can see, this is what I have to go through. This guy didn't see me coming in my wheelchair. You didn't see me coming? You know why I can't get up on the sidewalk? Because it's broken. So now you get an idea, and people wonder why people in wheelchairs are in a bad mood, because there's the world is just full of so ignorant, selfish people. Thinking about the needs of disabled people is not a thought of theirs at all. So this other street is South Park, just to give you an idea where we're at. And I'm going to keep this video rolling for a minute. Oh, I may as well show you a little bit more. See this curb cut out, this curb that's all, sorry, the sewer? This is a bicycle lane. You drive a bicycle down there and you hit that, you're going to have a really big problem. Otherwise, this intersection is relatively in good shape. If this light changes soon enough, I'll keep my video going. Just up there where those people are walking, right there, that's all a tar sidewalk. And the sidewalk is all wavy and rough. And I'm going to be able to get there and show it to you. In this neighborhood, there's a lot of wheelchairs. And you would think that they would have done a proper job with this sidewalk. Take a look at this, how dangerous this is. And believe me, you're not in a wheelchair, so you're not being jolted around on these stupid sidewalks that are all uneven. And the idea of continuing there is crazy. So I go over here. It may look smooth to you, but how would you like to be in a car that has no shocks? And you're bouncing all around all day long. Let me tell you, man, by the time you ride around in your car for a few hours, you'd be in horrific pain, and you'd be a real pain in the ass to everybody else, because the pain is quite unbearable when you've got disabilities. So now you're having another look at Halifax is a mess. You can go on YouTube and just type in Halifax is a mess, and you can see many more videos. And you go to wheelchairrights.wordpress.com and see, like right here, this is a series I did of the snowplows. All along here, the sidewalk should have been made wider long ago, but right there, you're looking at the damage that the snowplows do all winter long. And one of the things they do is they keep removing and removing and removing earth from the edge of the sidewalk so that there's a lip there. So if a wheelchair's tire catches that lip, the wheelchair is going to flip over. Anyway, oh, I hate being disabled, but I really hate the fact that I'm trapped in Toronto, that I'm trapped in Halifax, and I have no way to get out of this city. This city is so uncivilized, it's just absolutely amazing. An Accessibus, what a joke. Those things are always empty. They don't serve anybody. They tell you you've got to book 8 days in advance. And you can't do that if you're in a wheelchair, because you don't know if you can go out on that day, because you don't know what the weather's going to be. It should be like a 24-hour service. They've got computerized systems and to be able to do that. And they refuse to do that. And then when you book them, they say, well, we can't even guarantee we're going to be there. So Accessibus is completely useless for most people in wheelchairs. Thank you for listening.